Morning everyone. Today's session is in flexible AC transmission systems. Unit 2, objectives of static compensation, in which the first part deals with objectives of static shunt compensation, in which we have 4 points. One is midpoint voltage regulation, second one is voltage stability improvement, third transient stability improvement, last one is power oscillation damping. Among all these four, the first one is already completed in our course, that is midpoint voltage regulation, in which we have considered interconnected system comprising of two generators connected with a transmission line, and compensator is placed at middle of the transmission line to improve the voltage, that is midpoint voltage, equal to its sending end voltage must be equal to receiving end voltage. So all the three voltages Vs, Vm and Vr equal to V. So that was discussed in previous class. Now I would like to explain second part, that is voltage stability improvement. Voltage stability improvement is explained by a system comprised of a single generator feeding the load through a transmission line. It has two buses, bus 1 and bus 2 respectively. So bus 1 is connected to generator, bus 2 is connected to load. The best location of the compensator is at bus 2, that is at load bus. The voltage stability is ability of the system to maintain the steady acceptable voltages all over the network, particularly at load buses. So in power system network, 85% buses are load buses, and hence it is very important in power system to maintain the security of the system. So the voltage stability can be assessed by using graphical methods. So one among graphical methods is PV curve, power voltage curve. So this PV curve as shown in the left side of the bottom of the page. It is oval shaped, and the nose point indicates the critical point of the system at which dP by dV is equal to 0. So that is the condition for stability. The initial portion of the curve, or top portion of the curve, stable portion, and dP by dV is less than 0, negative, and bottom portion of the curve is unstable, the dP by dV is positive. And the distance between the operating point and the nose point is the available margin for the loading, or available stability margin, which can be improved by using compensator, shunt compensator at the load bus. Now let me explain PV curves of the said system without compensator and with compensator. The lower curve is without compensator. The distance between the operating point and the nose point is delta P1, which is the available stability margin for the system without any compensator. In the second case, the PV curve is enhanced, that is increased, and it is away from the origin compared to the previous curve as shown in the figure. By placing the compensator at the bus 2, we can enhance the PV curve. So, in which the distance between the operating point and nose point is delta P2, which is the available stability margin. Now, let us compare both the margins. Delta P2 is greater than delta P1, and hence the voltage stability of the system have been improved with the help of shunt compensator. Now let me explain the philosophy behind the shunt compensator and how it is improving the voltage stability. The first figure represents the generator feeding the load through a transmission line with the reactance X. Line reactance is X. And the set of PV curves indicates that each curve is done by maintaining the power factor of the system at a constant value. So the first curve is at 0.8 lagging power factor. The second curve 0.95 lagging power factor, third one is unity power factor, and so on. So these are the set of PV curves for different power factors. The power factor of the system can be improved by using a fixed compensator like a shunt capacitor. By using that shunt capacitor, the PV curves have been improved and the voltages may not be kept constant at 1 pu for all kind of compensators. Therefore, by increasing the size of the compensator, we can improve the voltage stability, but the voltages may not be at constant value. Whereas in the second case, the same system with compensator can be utilized for improving the voltage stability. At the same time, you can also ensure the constant voltages for different power factors. This is controlled compensation, either it is SVC, static wire compensator, or STATCOM. In both the cases, the power factor of the system can be maintained or improved. Simultaneously, the higher voltages, the maximum voltage, maximum possible voltage of the compensated system can be maintained at nominal voltage, that is 1 pu. As shown in the figure, right side corner down. And hence the basic philosophy behind the voltage stability improvement is the compensator improves the power factor and hence nose curve shifts away from the origin. Therefore, the available margin can be enhanced with the compensated system.